What does strength mean to a ninja? What does it mean to be the strongest? In order to find the answer,
Nine months. I know you probably hear this a lot, but starting off my channel 9 months ago with the Zabuza DLC, the season 2 launch day, I didn't expect the channel to be anywhere close to what it is now, let alone to even bother uploading for this long. When you ask YouTubers on advice for starting a channel, one of the first things they say is to just upload. Don't think about it too much, just upload and do what makes you happy. And that's essentially what I did. When I started seeing small progress on the channel, I set a goal for myself to reach 50 subscribers by the end of 2009. Sure enough, we almost touched 500, and my next goal was to get 1,000 by the end of this year. And now we're like 300 away from 2,000. Despite all the goals I set for the channel, we were able to always exceed them, which had you guys told me 7-8 months ago that I'd reach 1,000 before the end of 2020, I'd probably think you're someone who puts too much faith in unachievable milestones. There was just no way we were going to reach 1k by April. No way. Now I do want to send my apologies to those who are new to Strikers or who are just getting into it. That is a subscriber of mine, but you guys have to understand it from my perspective. I have been playing this game since the beta days. To be specific, I have over 1,500 hours put into Shinobi Strikers. That's approximately 62 and a half days of my life that I put into a video game. That's more than 2 full months. And I think there comes a time where every YouTuber, no matter what they're doing, eventually has to move on to different things. And it can be for many reasons. Some might look to expand their audience. Some could just generally be done uploading the content that they do. And in this case, for me, it's kind of both. I don't want anyone to get the impression that the main reason as to why I am done uploading consistent Striker videos is because of the lack of updates or the fact that we aren't getting DLC characters. It does play a part, but it is in fact not the main reason. The main reason is just because I'm exhausted, unmotivated to upload any Shinobi Striker video. As a Shinobi Striker YouTuber, I feel like I have done everything I could for the game. I've uploaded 68 different build videos. I've done tier lists. I've done so many useful tutorials. I've sacrificed sleep, literally staying up all night for the maintenances just to be the first person to showcase the DLCs and more. And even if there are a few good ideas I haven't done, it probably has been done already by someone else. So despite anything, whether a new DLC comes out in a month or two, that doesn't mean I'm going to come back as a Shinobi Striker YouTuber. I probably will upload a showcase because at the end of the day, I am a gaming YouTuber. And just like everyone else, we all want to show you the cool new content that has come to these games. But by no means does me uploading a Neji showcase mean I'm coming back or I just needed a break. The decision I made as of today is going to be permanent. When thinking on how I was going to make today's video, I thought about dividing into the issues of the game and just letting people know my current opinion on it. But then I realized, what's the point? This is probably going to be the last Shinobi Striker video I take seriously. And to be honest, eventually I might stop playing the game on my own time as well. So why end off today's video on a bad note when instead we can spend the remaining time we got on the good things? I don't think I've ever told anyone this, but there was a stretch of time to where Naruto Shinobi Striker was the most fun I've ever had in a video game. Ever. There was a time where I would put like 6 to 7 hours a day on the game because of how much fun I was having. The thing with me is I love online team oriented games. Some examples are like Star Wars Battlefront, Call of Duty, and even the new Resident Evil multiplayer game, Resident Evil Resistance. I also really like Naruto. So when you combine the two and bring a totally new gaming experience to us Naruto fans who were so used to having arena fighters over the past long years, it was exciting. I remember watching the trailer of Shinobi Striker, invested, played the beta and was even more invested and couldn't wait until release date. The early days of Shinobi Striker was one of the most fun I've ever had in a video game. Now when season 1 was close to being over, people assumed the game wasn't going to receive any more content because of its poor launch and the fact that the player base was at its lowest, even counting up to this day. Surprisingly, Bandai officially announced a Shinobi Striker Season 2, and that, to be honest, played a small part into how I was able to make it this far as a YouTuber. Like I said, I started my channel the exact day Zabuza released, and had it not been for a Season 2, I promise I probably would not have even bothered to be a YouTuber, because the only game I really had a passion for was Naruto Shinobi Striker. Had Sudil not worked their asses off to make Shinobi Striker a better experience, I probably wouldn't have been able to build as big as an audience as I did that quickly. And To that, I thank Sulil for their hard work after season one. But most importantly, I cannot forget about you guys. Not trying to get soft on y'all, but the support from the beginning till now was definitely the biggest factor. I never really interacted with people in the community itself, but I used to be in some community pages, Facebook and Reddit, to be exact. I don't know about now, but I can't say Shinobi Striker had the nicest group of people. What's crazy to me is even despite that, the support ratio was still 9-1 in my favor. I've gotten nothing but kind, funny, supportive comments in majority of my videos, and to that, I thank each and every one of you guys. I think when you're a subscriber and, you know, you leave a like and a comment and you think you're not really making an impact because everyone else is doing it, and some might think YouTubers themselves are probably not even reading the comments, nah, that ain't true. Nothing makes a YouTuber happier than the community interacting on their videos. If I did ever have any regrets during this 9-month stretch, it would definitely be not proving to you guys that despite what I upload, I can still be entertaining. 98% of my videos are Naruto Shinobi Striker. I never put as much effort into any game like I did with Strikers, and because of that, I'm aware that views and subs from here on out are going to decrease. In a way, I kind of look at it like starting over with a little boost. If I had to give any advice to someone starting their channel, it would be not to make the same mistake as I did and try to upload multiple games to prove to your audience that, hey, even if I stop uploading this game, I bet I can still entertain you guys with this one. Now, I don't want to make this video too long, so I'm going to wrap things up very soon. If you're curious as to what games I'll be playing in the future, My Heroes 1 Justice 2, Dragon Ball FighterZ, Dragon Ball Kakarot, I might be starting the Storm series over, SAO is coming out, Ghost of Tsushima, Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, and many, many more. I literally have a note app that has videos planned out until August. That's how good my organizational skills are. Now, but for real, every game, every upload I do from now on are only going to be ones that I want to make. Because if you're not having fun with the games you're playing, you're not getting the full experience. Now, what kind of YouTuber would I be if I didn't add a cliche farewell montage at the end? This has been your boy Chosen, and for the last time, thank you for watching my Striker videos for as long as you have, and I'll catch you on the next one. How's it going, everyone? This is your boy Chosen, and welcome to... I do occasionally try to interact and get my viewers involved, so don't miss out on the next chance to feature on a video. And with all that being said, let's make 2020 the best year possible, because we can only experience it once. 1,000 subscribers. Y'all don't even understand how happy this makes me. I know it's not the biggest milestone on YouTube, right? But what makes this achievement so important to me is that I feel like when you reach 1,000 subscribers, it's like the start of your YouTube career.
Want to fight?